Now, he once promised to wear a mankini on my satanic show. I told the producer, no, that wasn't going to happen. And it didn't, thankfully. But I've always had that fret over my head. Now, a promoter now, he's still doing the business, still close to the action. He's been and done it from Peckham to Las Vegas, which is, I believe, the name of his autobiography. It's friend of the show and old pal, Frank Maloney. Good evening, Frank.
Good evening, Steve. How are you?
Yeah, Frank, we're not doing the 2010. But if I had to ask you, marks out of 10... How would you rank marks out of 10 for you personally?
Last year, because I delivered 2 world title fights and a world eliminator, I would say 7.5 out of 10.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, you did have a good year. But let's look to 2011, Frank. Just give me the first few months. What have you got planned? I know you've got some fights already made, but remind me of what's made.
January, what? I've got young Jamie McDonald, defence of his European title.
Yeah, I like that kid. He's got a lot of attitude, hasn't he? I like him a lot, mate.
The 5th of February, I've got...
Sam Webb, is it?
Sam Webb against Bradley Price. He was originally supposed to fight Prince Aaron, but that's changed.
Why did that change? What happened to Aaron and Webb?
Aaron's had an injury, but I think Bradley Price is a much better fight.
Oh, yeah, it's exciting, yeah.
It's an exciting fight. Yeah. You know, Bradley comes to fight and wants to win all the time.
Yeah, it does, yeah.
Sam's developing well, and I think he's one of the...
He is developing well. You're right about that. That's a fair comment.
He's been a pro for a long time. People don't realise that. Yeah. But he's just coming into his own. And, you know, and I think next year, I think the two to watch is Tom Dallas and David Price. They're the ones I'm banking on, because there's heavyweight boxing and there's ordinary boxing, and I love heavyweight.
You love the heavies, Frankie, don't you? You love the heavies. You've got a big soft spot for them big lumps.
I'm sitting here in a restaurant in Dorking tonight, the little Dudley House, and I've got a couple of heavyweights here with me, and we're just I'm not going to say who they are. I'm trying to sign one of them up.
I hope it's not Anthony Joshua. I'm trying to get him on the show and he's not answering his phone, so if he's sitting opposite
you. It's not him. But they're taking liberties with me, you know.
Of course they would.
They're filling me full of champagne, hoping to get a better deal out of me.
No, they won't.
They won't, you're dead right. but, you know, next year is the year. I think the British heavyweight scene is very good next year.
So do I. It's really exciting scene.
You know, we've got John McDonald against Big Larry coming up in one of Frank Warren's shows in February, which is a good fight. It's the division to watch next year. I mean, there's a lot of other good fighters. You know, I could name about four or five of fights on my stable. There's young Paul Edwards, who won the flyweight title in Belfast,
December
the 15th. And I think, you know, I know he won on a controversial cut.
Doesn't matter,
I know
still
the rule's going to be changed in January and it wouldn't have happened. But you know what? He went out there and he done what he had to do. And, and we will give Shinny a rematch, there's no doubt about it. So we're not, you know, Paul Edwards is not trying to avoid the rematch, but he will give him a rematch. And there's young Ashley Sexton, who's fighting Martin Powers on February the 5th.
He's got a few things to say for himself. He's not afraid to talk, is he, actually?
No, the bantam weights, for every weight, I think there's some great fights out there. As long as us promoters are willing to put fighters in with each other's fighters and not protect our fighters. I think the days of protecting your fighters have got to be over.
I tell you what, Frank, I think that this is going to be the year when Sky put their foot down, and I think they're going to force one or two people to do business with each other, and I think that's a good thing. Personally.
No, I think it's a great look. The fights I'd like to see next year is James DeGale and George Groves.
Yeah,
I know which Frank is trying to make, and I'm sure Adam Booth will make it. You know, they'll sit down and make it.
Yeah, there's too much money involved. They're all talking good money.
It's David Price against Tyson Fury.
Come on, my son. Tyson Fury. I tell you, I'm going to leave you with this thought, Frank, and let you get back to the mill and do your business. Tyson Fury against Derek Del Boy Chisora. Now, that's the sort of fight I'm talking. Frank Maloney, it's always a pleasure.
Why not David Price against Chisora?
Well, listen, that's the second fight. Long term.
The winner can fight Tyson Fury.
All right, Frank, listen, it's always a pleasure. Frank Maloney, their manager and an old school manager at that, if you don't mind me saying so.